Hey YouTube, Chad the Economist here. I'm gonna do something a little fun today. I'm gonna give you a tour of my car, or my Instacar, as I should call it. So let's get started.
Let's start with the steering wheel. I got this awesome steering wheel cover with the gel pads there. Helps keep my hands from getting calluses on them. You can see I got my water bottle right here with the, this is a beer koozie, but the 500 ml plastic water bottle fits in there perfectly. Usually I use a, you know, like a sports water bottle, but with the whole coronavirus thing going on, I'm just using disposable plastic ones. You might have noticed those cases in the background on some of my other recent videos. So that's awesome. I have a couple more of those, which I'll show you in a second. Between the driver's seat and the door, I have this awesome LED flashlight here. Kind of pointless showing you this in the sun, but I'll show you some footage of this at night. It's super, super bright, and it's also super durable. You could use this as a weapon if you needed to. Over here in the driver pocket, I got a little tiny little push button umbrella just in case I need it, and pepper spray just in case. Never had to use that. So let's go inside the car here. You can see I got my Android on the magnetic phone mount here, just mostly for show. These magnetic phone mounts are way better than the clamp ones. You just stick it on and it stays in place. See, I got two cables, the red ones for my iPhone, and the silver one is for the Android. Down here, I got my Mentos gum. I love this. Buy this stuff in bulk. It's got this hard candy shell, so it stays, it won't melt, especially in this Florida sun. Got some chapstick, my glasses. Over here, I only have one quarter left. Usually this little area is filled with quarters for the shopping cart at Aldi, but I'm down to my last quarter. Over here is my little collection of homemade face masks. If you get face masks like this, make sure you mark which side is the clean side, which side is the dirty side. And I also added an N and a C, so for nose and chin, so I know which way is which. Over here, we got a couple little gadgets. This is, I got this at Michael's. You know, it's for, I use this for DoorDash if I get an order with a bunch of drinks. Don't use it that much. Over here is my lunch box. I already ate lunch, so it's empty right now. But you know, it's got this little Tupperware thing for sandwich, and then it's got a little ice pack down there, and you know, throw apple and whatever in there, and like put chips right here. And then here's my other water. I got two. I always keep two more things of water when I leave the house, and it's awesome. I got this, you know, ice blanket thing. I throw this in the freezer, and I wrap it around the water bottles to keep them cool. And I got this awesome. I don't know where I got this. Just a half cardboard box there, perfect for that, and I'll throw that down there. Over there, you can see some Walmart brand disinfectant spray. I'll use that for like if I'm pulling up to somewhere where I have to punch in a gate code or something, just spray that down. Here's my Amazon Flex vest. Just keep that right there in case I ever have Amazon Flex block. Over here, you see my collection of lanyards and badges. Here's Dispatch. This is a new company I just started driving for. It's mostly Sherwin-Williams deliveries. Nobody's ever asked to see this, so it's just there. I've got two Instacart lanyards with the old school pointless badges. I've got a DoorDash lanyard. I got that just for kicks, and I use that to keep the DoorDash red card right there. That way I never lose it, and this black card is the Uber Eats equivalent of their red cards. Uber Eats just started doing order and pay, and it's not even at fast food restaurants. Now here's my Orlando City lanyard, and I keep a Sharpie around my neck for when I'm doing double or triple orders, or sometimes I just label heavy or cold or fragile in the paper bags. I always get paper bags. And I got a purple, the phone holster. I've showed this in other videos. And then here's my Instacart green heart card. That way it's always right there. Let me show you what you got in the glove box here real quick. See this little medicine cabinet of Pepto-Bismol, you know, Advil, little first aid kit, a Tide stain stick, some lens cleaning wipes I use for the phone when it gets smudgy and all that. Here is an extra green card. You should always have two. Keep one in your glove box or somewhere safe in case you ever lose yours. And I have an extra phone holster because I've gone through a few of these. The rubber tends to break after a while, and then you're stuck without these for a few days until you get another one. So I order two and just keep an extra one in the car. And I have another red card I keep in here for DoorDash for the same reason. And a couple extra Sharpies.
Oops, almost forgot to show you what's in the center console.
So this is an old dish rag I use for when I'm eating out. I just drape it over my lap here. That way ketchup, mustard, all that stuff doesn't spill on my clothes. I always keep a bunch of napkins down here. And since it's Florida, I always keep a, you know, a little bottle of dollar store sunblock. You'd be surprised how quick I go through that. Here is the Instacart hand sanitizer spray mist. And here is the DoorDash spray gel. They sent us some plastic gloves too, but I don't use those plastic gloves as far as what I've heard. They're just pretty pointless. And a little thing of travel size, you know, bug repellent. All right, so in the door pockets, I have my Rate Me 5-star stickers. I sell these, well, I sell the templates for these on my website. You can get sticker paper, just print them out, and then just cut them out with scissors. It's really easy. And in the door pockets, I have these. These are for if you're getting plastic shopping bags, it makes it really easier to carry. They're just D-clamps, like with a padded, you know, side there. So I very rarely use those. I use them for like if I'm doing Walmart deliveries for a DoorDash, but I haven't had to do one of those in a while. By the way, you might notice that in my back seat here, the seats are up. If I'm doing rideshare, I just fold them down like that. Otherwise, I just leave them up all the time. And you can see on the other door handle here, I got some more stickers and two more of the D-clamps. Over here behind the passenger seat, this pocket here, I've got this Swiffer duster. I'll use that just like when I'm going to the car wash, wipe down the dash. In fact, I can see it's dusty right now. Or if I'm sitting in traffic or just waiting on a batch or something. I've got these signs I use for when I'm doing a double or triple shop, or if I just have to go to the bathroom. I leave this in the shopping cart so people don't think it was abandoned. Just lets them know that I'm coming back. Here are some extra index cards and Velcro dots for my insulated bags. I'll show you those in a second. And then I have a couple notepads and pens here. Use these for when I have to place a deli order or sub or something. I go there straight, you know, swipe to start shopping, and then just write down what the customer wants and leave it on the counter there. So let's check out the trunk area. It might look messy, but trust me, it's actually pretty organized. These are something I just got. These are called Lotus trolley bags. There are four bags. They're all Velcro, and you just, you know, you put them into the shopping cart directly, and they spread out like an accordion, and you can use them for different compartments. It's great for when you're doing double or triple shops, so you know whose stuff is who. Over here, I have three DoorDash bags. If I'm doing DoorDash, I'll keep one up on the front seat, or I'll keep it in the back seat there. You see my red wagon here. This is actually a new one. You know, it folds up and down. I've used that all the time. It's great. Over here is my drying towel for when I go to the car wash. Like I said, I just came back from the car wash. If I've ever had a massive spill, that would be a good first response or whatever. And of course, you can see all my Ozark Trail 50 can cooler bags with the Velcro dots on there. It looks like, oh, this one's missing one. And keep the A, B, and C index cards right in the pocket there. So when I'm doing double or triple shops, you just stick it on there. So that way I know whose bag is whose. I used to have these in a bunch of different colors and just kind of got lost or damaged over the years. So I pretty much just have red now. Oh, and I have a couple more paper bags down here too. You can see the rubber lining on here. Just in case I ever had a major spill, it wouldn't affect the car. Let me show you one more thing. I just started doing this. This is a sticker.co. It's kind of turns your car into a taxi. You just get paid to run this ad on the back of your car. I literally just started doing this, so I'm not sure how much money I'll make. So we'll come back in like a month. But if you're interested, I'll put a link in the description below. So that is it as far as what's in the car. But let me show you a couple more things I keep inside the house I use for the car. You know, turtle wax, upholstery cleaner, just like a foaming thing, like with a scrub brush here. You get chocolate or, you know, ketchup or mustard or whatever on your seats. That's good at getting it out. These are just kind of like Armor All wipes, just generic Walmart brand. Here's a scratch remover, you know, superficial clear coat scratches, not deep gouges. I use that every once in a while. Goo Gone. I think everybody knows about Goo Gone. You know, it's about like if you take a bumper sticker off your car and it's got that, you know, adhesive stickiness on there. This is good at getting that out. And then there's also citral, which is essentially the same thing as Gougon as far as what they're advertising it for. But I like the where it says and more. This is great at getting bugs off your car, especially love bugs, especially right now, this time of year. I'll show you a before and after picture of what my bumper looked like covered in love bugs, and then using, you know, citral and just like a heavy duty sponge here to get them out. This might be the most important thing I own. This is a portable tire inflator. You just run it right into the cigarette lighter there. It's got a digital readout. You can set it to whatever you want. So 32 is what it's at, and I prefer to keep my tires at 33 PSI. So I just hit play there. Yeah, so it filled it up in like, what, 10 seconds? I check my PSI like every 2 weeks or so. If I had room, I would keep this in the car at all times. I just don't really have room. If you have a truck or SUV or a minivan, you probably have room. So get one of these, keep it in the car at all times, and check your PSI every 2-3 weeks. All right, so I'm going pretty long. Thanks for watching. I'll put links to all the stuff I showed in the description below, and I'll see you guys next time.